The leaders of the G8 summit will be meeting here in a month's time at the same location. The issues that we have discussed over these past 2 days will be presented for them to discuss.
Well, when I first heard that this was being organised, I was really excited about that, because the fact is we're here in the Lough Erne Golf Resort where the G8 is going to happen, so the world leaders will be here. And the fact that young people have really staked their claim first, as it were, I think is a very good mark for the G8, because they're going to talk about issues affecting them. They're going to talk about their vision for themselves, for young people, for the world, and then they're going to present those. And I think that's a very exciting start to what hopefully is the start of the build-up now to the G8.
We've really been just listening to international speakers tell their stories, really just to inspire us, and then we've been discussing issues that we think are really important, and then just sort of putting the young person's spin on the issues that we've been discussing.
We've been discussing major issues both domestically and globally that are affecting the youth of today, and they're mainly kind of social, economic issues, issues on healthcare, such as in particular mental health.
Primarily we've been conducting in group work discussing main issues that we think that affect the youth of today. We've also been hearing speeches from international speakers. We heard one from Caroline Casey and one from Canuck Dixit, and they're both really inspirational and inspired me for my future anyway.
We've been brainstorming issues that are important to us as young people and then putting them into mind maps so that we kind of get a general idea of what everybody's common ground is, like what the common issues are for everyone, and then trying to sum them up into a formal presentation that we can give to the leaders as a young people's voice.
I personally have got a lot more understanding for governments, and it's opened my eyes to a lot of problems and kind of given me a lot to think about. Also, it's given me some goals to set for the future.
I think our youth feel kind of trudging on at times because we've focused so much on the past rather than what we can do in the future. So I think we really need to push the youth because, you know, we are the future.
I'm really glad that we can have a voice and that we can share our issues with the leaders so that they can take that on board and maybe try to resolve some of those as well.
It's been great. I've learned quite a lot, met loads of new people, so it's been a really valuable experience.
I've enjoyed working with other people that I wouldn't have otherwise met if I hadn't been to this conference, and the fact that, you know, I'm engaging in kind of topics that would impact us a lot at the minute, and the fact that, you know, we're having the crack at the same time as, you know, doing proper work.
Well, young people are important to our society. It's important they're given a choice to get their message out and to hear what the views of other people are, because it's important that young people come together, get politically aware and know what's going on in the world and realise that they can make a difference, even if it's only one person taking a stand.
My message would be to keep doing what you're doing, keep coming together and building relationships with other young people, keep knocking on doors and keep making sure your voice is heard.
My message to the G8 leaders would be to remember the young people and remember that their voice is the voice of the future as well, and that they are just as important, and that some of the issues we are discussing are shared by a lot of people and should be addressed.
This is Una, Wimps TV, reporting from the Lough Erne Resort in Fermanagh.